Today in our Live Healthy segment, we are talking about children and supplements. This after this week, a new study revealed 1/3 of children regularly use alternative medicines, vitamins, energy stimulants, digestive aids. But are these safe? Joining us now to discuss the findings of this national study is Dr. Shalaka Ghate, who is with Memorial Family Medicine. Good morning. Thank you for being here. I do appreciate it. What was your reaction when you saw this? Were you surprised that so many kids are taking these kind of alternative supplements?
Yes. I'm surprised that their parents are allowing them to take these kind of supplements, which contain so many different vitamins, omega-3s, energy supplements. I'm surprised that this is going on.
Yeah, so let's talk about some of the common things that this study revealed. You touched on some of them, the omega-3 fatty acids, vitamin D, melatonin, vitamin C. For those not familiar with omega-3 fatty acids, why would a parent want their child to take that?
Omega-3 is a good supplement for general health. It does help lower your cholesterol. It helps, brain functioning, and it has a lot of good effects that it can give. But I just feel that it's not necessary for kids to take supplements. They should rather be eating those substances in the natural form.
Well, it's interesting, too, because I remember, and my children are 13 and 11 now, my pediatrician told me my kids don't need any kind of a vitamin or anything of that nature. So do you think, based on, and we've got some statistics on the age here, that maybe these are teenagers who are walking into the, health food store and buying these, maybe not telling mom and dad,
right?
And just deciding, hey, I don't have great energy, let me just kind of take a pill and that'll make it better?
I think that actually taking these may sometimes put them at risk for different side effects because they could run into high vitamin levels. Some of the energy supplements could have substances that can actually make their heart race and do so many other different things to their nervous system as well. So I think they are posing dangerous side effects on these kids.
Yeah, I think it is interesting too. Do you think that maybe particularly kind of preteens and teens assume that if they can buy it off the counter that it won't hurt them? And boy, the government, FDA must have approved this if it looks like it's in this fancy sort of medicine bottle.
Correct. The problem with these vitamins are they're made by so many different companies that I'm not sure if the FDA is regulating these. I'm more worried about the other additives as well that could be added to these while they're being manufactured.
Are there, though, some children who would benefit from taking supplements and vitamins?
Yes, sure. In my practice, I do recommend supplements based on their lab values. If a child or a teenager has certain deficiencies found by their doctors or are suffering from any kind of illness or medical condition that could be affecting the absorption, then definitely I recommend these patients to take these kind of supplements, but they are more specific to their need, and that's what is so important.
And having that conversation, right, even if your kids, when we take our kids for their yearly and they're young, we're actively involved, but as they get older and they're kind of going to meet with the doctor by themselves, maybe meeting with the doctor as a parent and saying, hey, is there something I need to make sure my child is taking in regards to supplements if their cholesterol or anything else comes back or their iron comes back low?
I think there should be more awareness among parents and even us as physicians, as family practice, and also pediatricians that we need to have this conversation with the kids and their parents to watch out for these supplements because they can have dangerous side effects.
Particularly those containing iron, right?
Yes.
Dr. Ghate, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me
here. Parents, of course. And by the way, if you missed any of this interview, we are going to post it in its full entirety later this morning. Just look under the Live Healthy tab on newsforjax.com.